Welcome to the part 2 of our lesson discussion on the patterns of development. Hello dear learners, this is Renette. Once again, welcome back to the part 2 of our lesson on the patterns of development. We discussed in our previous lesson the 5 patterns of development. What are they? Let's recap. They are the definition, exemplification, chronology or procedure, description, and the last is comparison and contrast. If you haven't yet watched the part 1 of our lesson discussion, please click the link above. Now, are you ready for our next pattern of writing? Let's proceed to the 6th pattern is the cause and effect. The words cause and effect are very common when we say, what's the cause of global warming? What are the effects? We can answer that there is global warming because of too much carbon dioxide. That's one cause. What is the effect? One is the intense temperatures around the world. That's a possible effect. Meaning, a cause is simply why something happens and an effect is what happens. Together, they can be used as a pattern of development in writing. So what's the best graphic organizer to use? I think it is fishbone map. Have you tried using it? Look at the fishbone map here. You can see here the cause category and the effect, which is the problem. With the cause and effect pattern, the writer can explain how an event or action leads to another. These are guide questions before you write this pattern of writing. Questions like, why did it happen? What caused it? What does it cause? What are its effects? And how is it related to something else? Here are some signal words for causes and effects. Let's try to take a look at this example. The topic sentence is found at the beginning of the paragraph. Stating the cause, then the next sentence or the rest of the sentences are the effects of the illness called salmonellosis. What are some signal words? They are consequently and furthermore. All right? The 7th pattern is problem solution. There's a famous cliche that in every problem, there's always a solution. Well, this pattern divides information into 2 main sections, one that describes a problem and one that describes a solution. The problem section usually includes the why questions such as who, what, where, why, and how of the problem. The other part presents the major effects of the problem and the possible solutions. Mostly when you use this pattern, this requires more paragraph because you need to write the details of the problem and the solution to the problem. Well, as you can see in this paragraph, the underlined are some signal words found in the paragraph. How many signal words can you identify? You have however, nonetheless, first, the second, to do this, what more? I hope you can still find. The 8th pattern is the classification and division. When you classify, you try to sort or arrange things into groups or categories or divisions according to their common or shared characteristics. In English, there are so many topics. Writing is even classified into 2, the academic and non-academic writing and other disciplines. These are some signal words for classification and division. You need to consider these questions when you write classification and division pattern, such as, what are its parts or types? How can its parts or types be separated or grouped? In what categories can its parts or types be arranged? Here is our example. Try to find some signal words in this paragraph. One is the first, also known as the second, the last. And the last pattern is persuasion. What do you expect from this pattern? You write to convince. Specifically, this pattern presents the issue, your position, and the supporting evidence that supports the position. Some guide questions are, what is the issue? What is your position or opinion? What is the opposing position or opinion? What are some reasons for your position? That's why you need to write a position paper. Okay? The best to apply is when you write your position paper. What are some cases or examples that support this? So when you try to identify or write a persuasion pattern, take note of these guide questions. Consider also these signal words before writing. Signal words for emphasizing a point. Signal words for concluding and summarizing. We also have signal words for conceding a point. And here's the example of persuasion pattern. All right, we finished discussing all the 9 patterns of development in writing. How is it? Is it easy? In general, while signal words help you understand in identifying the different patterns of development, but getting the main idea is much more important. Which patterns of writing is your favorite? Now, are you ready for our quiz? It's time to identify the main idea, the pattern of development, and the signal words in each paragraph. Ready? Let's read it all together. First, tap create account. It's at the bottom of the page. Enter your full name and tap next. Enter your birthday and gender and tap next. Tap your desired username and tap next. Create your password that should be at least 8 characters long and tap next. Enter your phone number and tap next. Google will send you a verification code. Enter the verification code and tap next. Review terms of service and tap agree. What is the main idea of the paragraph? It is about how to set up your Gmail account. So what type of pattern? It is chronological or procedural. So the second paragraph, what's the main idea? The traffic in Metro Manila. You can check the signal words. And what type of pattern? It is persuasion. The third paragraph, what's the main idea? The classification of dogs. And you can check the signal words. And the pattern? Of course, it is classification. The fourth one. Next paragraph. What's the pattern? It is comparison and contrast, particularly on the Eastern and Western culture. Let's proceed to the fifth paragraph. Let's read. What is the main idea? About tsunami information. The signal words, you can see the underlined ones. What's the pattern? It's obvious. It is definition. The sixth one, what's the main idea? It's flooding in the Philippines. And let's check the signal words. And what is the main pattern? Problem, solution. The seventh one is this. Read this paragraph. What's the idea? Reasons of living in the metro. You check the signal words. And what's the pattern? Exemplification. Oh, the second to the last. Let's read. Can you spot the signal words? Of course, the underlined words. And the pattern is description. And the final paragraph. Let's read again the paragraph. What's the main idea? It is about bullying in school. The signal words are the underlined ones. And the pattern, cause and effect. After identifying the main idea, signal words, and the type of pattern, I hope you are now ready to write a paragraph or even an essay. If you have some questions, feel free to write them in the comment section below. Happy learning, everyone. See you.